Jason and Galbadia. Gonna do some assassination. I wasn't actually planning on playing tonight, but I was hit with the urge to play, so let it go on record that I actually am playing Final Fantasy VIII because I want to tonight. Oh god, what was happening? I got stuck here somehow? What was I doing? Oh. I solved it. Okay, yeah, so I'm trying to get to the big end of Act 1 checkpoint, at the very least, tonight. I'm very excited to see Squall. That it starts storming up again and I will lose my internet connection. But I will worry about that. Dealing with Twitch on my phone, but okay, sounds fine. Take the headphones off because they annoy me. The sewer maze would be more interesting if it wasn't just like the same two rooms over and over again. But, like, the symbol of Galvadia is just everywhere now that I've noticed it once. Some iron grates. I don't know why it interests me. It's not very interesting. I've gone this way before, though. But I think it's because it's just the same two rooms over and over again. Okay, so the team are just gonna blast through these guys. Yes. Oh god, I'm almost back to my post that I abandoned. Oh, team. We did it. Gateway team? Is that what these guys were called? Go right to the top. No. Go right to the top. Selfie, your head. Gun? Okay. That's more what I expected. Is it gonna let me switch my party? I don't think I want to do that, actually. I'm just gonna heal everybody up a little bit. I feel like it is about boss time. Do I have the swords? Probably should say. I honestly don't remember. I guess the guards are fighting people who are trying to stop them. The sorcerers were. Why didn't they show that violence breaking out before this? This gate. mean, I guess it stops vehicles, but he didn't even have to try to weasel in there. Telling me to, like, I don't feel anything. This doesn't feel like a big stakes moment. That's something that's been building up. I need to heal. I need to heal, my boy. I don't have high potion. Okay, there we go. Ooh. Yeah, I don't know. I guess it's just like, I know it's a big iconic moment in this game, but the character arc's beginning with them fucking up each other's faces. Like, what? We're gonna start with that? There's not gonna be any lead up to that? And from there, it's kind of a tell-don't-show situation. Cypher's your rival, because we assigned him that role. Fight him a bunch throughout the game. I don't remember exactly how many times in the game, actually. I know there's this one, and I remember there's one much closer to the end of the game. Because my first time playing through, that's where I got stuck and never got past. As you are, because that was boring and I didn't do anything fancy. What a nothing metaphor. Oh, I do fight her. You did shoot her like you were supposed to. Okay. was going to be a long battle. I guess I will dig in my heels and grab some magic when I can.
We'll be right back.
falling off like a 5-foot tall tree. Alright, and that was it. That was the equivalent to the end of disc one. So now we start getting into the really weird stuff. It's Laguna again. Speak to children. Okay, I'll save on up. Oh wait, no, I just saved. It just let me save. Never mind. Hi, Callie, are you awake? Ooh, cute little arm. Full of bullet holes? Is that what that is? Oh my god. This is getting kind of maudlin. Like he was talking to the pictures of her dead parents, right? Okay. This is where I'm going. Wears. Because in the PS1 version, it looks like he's not wearing pants. He does dress funny. I'm gonna give you that one. Very tight clothing. Thank you. Remastered music. What are you talking about? That's Renella's dad. Hasn't it only been 6 months? Oh, I guess there might have been more of a time skip since you last saw Julia. Alright, Squall's still here. Okay, the 6 months was how long he was bedridden, and has been more than 6 months. Never mind. That was me not putting things together correctly. Well, I didn't think so. I guess he did too. There were monsters, giant caterpillars in the back. Fine. Shiva, but magic, I guess. Good enough. What's this big building? Oh, won't let me go in. Mind your own business. Let me in the building. Okay, so my job is to kill monsters. Think the fauna would be a theory is that when Skull gets impaled by those icicles that just happened a couple minutes ago, that he dies at that point in the game, and everything that happens in the game after that is just like his brain cells in the throes of death firing off their last few electrical pulses and coming up with a weird, you know how, like, when you're starting to fall asleep and you're not quite asleep, and you're still able to think, kind of, but it's operating off weird dream logic, like, that kind of thing, except he's not falling asleep, he's dying. And the reason for that theory to come about is that it doesn't quite make sense that he survived getting impaled by icicles. The story just gets exponentially weirder, and it's been pretty weird so far already. But, like I said, it's one of those edgy, grimdark theories, but I like that one when I normally don't like those ones, those kinds of things, because it, I don't know, it actually does something to explain why things get so bizarre in this game. And why, like, character arcs don't really make any sense and just kind of veer off in random directions from what they were before the point where Squall got impaled by icicles. So it does kind of seem like he's dreaming up everything that's happening. Granted, this theory doesn't account for, I mean, it doesn't discount the Laguna stuff, but, like, the Laguna stuff and the fact that Squall can relive Laguna's memories, even though he's never met Laguna, is weird and confusing, and all of that is canon before he theoretically dies, so. So Squall's dead theory doesn't really do anything to explain the Laguna flashbacks, but. Okay. Chocobos. I haven't seen any chocobos yet. Or no, I might have seen one when I was doing the train heist, but in the background. I haven't had a chance to ride a chocobo yet. Appreciate it if this game explained the things that I'm supposed to be doing before I do them and not when I'm halfway through doing them. But it's fine, I guess. What a cute little town. Come up with these theories for, like, children's entertainment, but I guess Final Fantasy is kind of for children's entertainment, but it's not like Final Fantasy itself has never pulled the "and this character was dead all along" twist. Like, it's not like, you know, the fucking Rugrats theory where it's just like, oh, what if all the babies were dead and it's actually dark secretly, and it's like, no, the main character being dead for 75% of his own game is actually the kind of nonsense that Final Fantasy would pull. And they have pulled some similar nonsense, not that exact nonsense. She does not want me around. This is a cute fucking house. he doesn't want me here. Yeah, I got your implications, ma'am. Right, Tally? Can you believe the way that lady talked to me? Oh, there's that fucking moon again. I'll have to talk about the moon at some point before, Oh, do I want to get in here? It looks kind of like a sheer cliff and not a path, so I'm not sure if I'm walking down a path or jumping off a sheer cliff. I'm just fighting these easy battles, so I might as well talk about my two favorite plot points in this game that have haunted me for years and are my two main reasons, I think, for hanging on to the bitter resentment for Final Fantasy VIII for so long. Like, it's not enough that this game is, like, not well-designed. Like, okay, see that? This is bad design. Bad design, Tally. But the two plot points I pull out as examples of really the epitome of Final Fantasy VIII's nonsensical plot twists that I'm pulling every 7 seconds. The reveal that Adia is possessed by a sorceress from the future. I didn't even get into the part where she's also secretly everybody's mom, which is also bonkers. But the whole explanation of she's evil because she was possessed by a future sorceress. I just fucking hate that because I don't know what's happening. It just completely defangs Adia as a villain. And it... Oh, your limit break. It's just a bunch of nonsense. It's just like, when she reveals this to the main characters, it's just like she's stringing words together at random, it feels like. To come up with the most shocking plot twist imaginable instead of something that's, you know, consistent with the story up until this point and consistent with her character, but it turns out everything I knew about her character didn't matter, because she was just possessed the whole time, and she's not really evil. She is everybody's mom. Which, I think is poisoned, probably. Which, if she was, like, if she was in control of her own actions and not just possessed the whole time, her being everyone's mom would actually be an interesting plot point. I mean, it's still wild. It's bonkers. It doesn't make sense, and it ruins the characterization and the character dynamics and characterization of everyone else up until this point. So it sucks anyway, but it gets worse once they're all like, we were all siblings the whole time, and we had amnesia for no reason. And that's why we were all weird around each other. And now we're all gonna continue being weird around each other. And it's like, why? Why did anyone think that this was, like, good or interesting characterization? The background artists, on the other hand, I've been saying a lot of negative things. I'm going to say something positive about the background artists. They are doing more to tell the story of this game than any of the dialogue. Dialogue in this game fucking sucks. But okay, I was going to let it slide with Rain's comment about speaking proper English, but that is a map of the real world and real world continents hanging on the wall, so a slight ding to the background artist that I was just complimenting. That doesn't make any sense and breaks the immersion, but it's okay. It's Final Fantasy VIII. I was not that immersed to begin with. cute, and I'm talking. Oh, kind of. So yeah, idea of being secretly possessed is one of my pet peeve plot points in this game, and the other one is, and I believe it's been a very long time since I played the game the first time, but I believe that this is the verbatim way that Dr. Odin revealed this plot point. Quote, "As you know, monsters come from the moon." That refers to the lunar spring? I forgot exactly what the event is called, but it's basically the point in this game when the moon gets on its period and just bleeds monsters onto the surface of the planet. But I hate that plot point because... I hate that, first of all, it's delivered to you, the player, in the form of, as you know. Oh. What? Stop breaking the fourth wall, guys. You guys, I'm trying to talk about monsters come from the moon. Speculative fiction, introducing world-building elements with someone saying to a character who lives in that world, as you know, blah 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 blah. It's bad writing. It's real bad writing. And aside from that, as is kind of evident by what I'm doing right now, it was never in question where monsters came from in this game before that point, as far as I can remember. Like, they were just angry animals world, as far as I can tell, and that's honestly explanation enough for why I have to fight them. Like, I know some Final Fantasy games do explain why there are monsters in the world, like 9 and 10 and 15 all do that, I think. But in all of those cases, I don't normally have a lot of nice things to say about 15 either, so I'm not just picking on Final Fantasy 8 because I don't like it in general. Like, other Final Fantasies that I don't like have been able to do this successfully. But they explain early on in the game where monsters come from. And their explanation is something that ties intrinsically into the overall plot. In this game, the Lunar Scream, or whatever it's called, is just a thing that happens late in the game for no reason. As best I can remember. And it just doesn't tie in with any of the stuff that happened before that point. And they can, you know, put the moon in the background as much as possible and be like, ah, we did foreshadow this, though. You can't say we didn't foreshadow it. And it's like, yeah, but you didn't need to... It didn't need to be a thing. Like, it doesn't contribute to the story in any meaningful way. Like, I'm fighting monsters right now, that's my whole thing that I'm doing right now. And you can see, these guys are never like, oh man, where did all these monsters come from? Even though, and this, it seems like it would be a pertinent question if it was something that anyone really bothered to question. Now I'm out of breath complaining about plot points I don't like. What? why do they spell you that way? That would still be the phonetic pronunciation of that would still be pronounced you. Wouldn't he have already left? Think about it, Rain. Her sweater looks cozy as fuck. Living in envy right now. Understand the blue and yellow text either. Like, I know it's like, this is something you're supposed to pay attention to, but sometimes it's blue and sometimes it's yellow, and I don't know why, and I don't know why it's in brackets. That doesn't make sense at all. That seems like one of those things in older RPGs where you can, or not even necessarily older RPGs, just more roleplay based RPGs where you get like information that you're supposed to ask other NPCs about later. Everybody's poisoned. Just get through it, guys. We'll get through this. I'll give you antidotes after the fight. Like, I should be able to bring those keywords around this little puzzle later. Something I'm supposed to pay attention to, I guess. She's been watching me play, listening to me rant. I tried to assassinate a sorceress. It did not work, and Squall died.
Oh my god, everything I hear about this game just proves how little I know about this game.
Squall probably didn't die, that's just like the big fan theory.
Oh, no, I was talking about the assassination.
Oh, yeah, no, that was real.
I have no clue what is happening. I know there's a death.
Yeah, that happened. But I tried to assassinate a sorceress in the middle of a parade. And then she kicked my ass. And now I'm back in Laguna time.
Sorry. I've been killed.
She's sharp. Even Squall in there. That was Zell. Yeah, Squall's totally dead. You know what? I buy into Squall as a dead theory 100% now. Oh no. No, okay, Zell was in Ward's head. Now. I don't care for that. This is the end of the game. What do I do? I'm trying. Oh my god. Where did I go? Guys. Oh my god. Okay, Renoa, you seem to be more on the right track. Better roll it back there. You don't get a call right now, stupid. Yeah, Dia's probably gonna blame the president dying on you guys. Is he not dead? Yes. Oh my god. I'm in it 110%. Squall's dead. I don't know. It just makes it more interesting, I think. Like, that scene that I just got through with all the kids in prison, I think, really happened. But this here. Like, this, I think, is all Squall's dying fever dreams. What the hell? These are children. You don't need to go to this amount of trouble. Is this a puzzle dungeon? I don't have the energy for that. Get beat up. No, I don't cooperate with cops. What kind of anti-fascist are you? This guy on the right who can't decide where to point his gun. It looks like he's pointing it at the mean guy. Well, now it looks like he's pointing at Renault, but... this. What? Oh my god. Oh, right, Moombas. Numera's sad attempt to usurp Moogles in popularity did not stick. Oh, the symbolism. See? The symbolism! The whole rest of my playthrough is going to be me finding things that prove Squall's dead theory. But does this symbolism insinuate that he comes back to life? Conversation just seems bizarre. And excessive. Be the same chicken was who blurted out key information that almost got you all executed, right? Yeah, Nisha, I think Cypher is right. I think he would talk instantly. That Cypher's talking about, it just seems like things that Squall remembered him saying and just like grasping for words that he associates with Cypher. I see, like I was saying when I was fighting him earlier, the build-up for their rivalry doesn't seem like it justifies the kind of emotional intensity that they're trying to hearken to in this scene. But if Squall were dying and his brain was just like scrambling for information about Cypher, would be right after I fought him. So of course Squall would be like, yeah, Cypher's my mortal enemy. He just tried to kill me, and then someone else killed me, and now I'm dead. Are you drawing from him to does that work? Can you do that? Have to Have to do what's right, Zell. Defend that tiny lion. Oh, it worked. Necessary, but okay. So yeah, this conversation doesn't make any sense. Like, Cypher was training to be in Seed. Why would he be asking this? I mean, I know Squall himself just pointed that out. Hasn't really provided a decent explanation for that. With missiles? Why doesn't she use magic? It's because she's so extra. Suddenly cares about things. That's suspicious too. That's a change. Should be every space one, I believe, but let it slide. Just kidding, I just called it out. Don't mind me just copy editing this. Old game? No, it's not 20 years old. How old is it? No, it is. It is 20 years old, isn't it? I guess if someone, you know, was holding you prisoner and electrocuting you and just shouting the same. You're already dead. Tell lies. Final Fantasy II reference. I guess it kind of is. It kind of is a similar metaphor, isn't it? I'm going off the rails with that lie. Well, oh no. Okay, well, I guess I can't talk to the Moomba. So wait, hold on. I want to make sure I have this right. So sitting down, I got up, I walked over to Kisti's, so that the game would steer me back to where I was just sitting and sit me back down. It's the little things about this game that make it especially grating. Oh, it's healthy. Oh my god. Why would you say that? charge, Lenzel. Cover story, man. He's passed out with his whole ass in the air. One weapon. Or no, is that both of them? Oops. That's fine. Yes. Oh, they got all the weapons. Yeah, the gunblade too. I didn't even see that the first time. Those regular blades. Maybe it's just a regular blade. Why does it look weird? Oh well. Oh well, I'm full of criticisms tonight. For the background. Good. That was a piece of cake. And I was just complaining about a potential puzzle dungeon coming up, but that was a little too easy to be interesting. Yeah, I got him in like 5 seconds, guys. Whoa, what? What? Stop. What is happening? I know that they have the weapons back. Why is this happening? Who invited you? Ugh. You gonna get in on that weird moment? God, do I have to fix everyone's junctions again? I'm so tired. She was my mage, right? Oops. Oh well. I'll fix it. The nearest safe point, because all this junctioning is draining my will to continue existing in this horrible universe. And by that I mean the world of Final Fantasy VIII. I'm actually gonna switch that around. I don't know. Those guys. Oh man, I thought one of you died. The comedic timing in this game is bad. Another pointless Ball's Dead theory. I'm pretty sure one of these guys died. Actually, I think it was Wedge. Or not. Whichever the blue one is. Oh no. What's he doing? 11.